chance. In front. They score. It's off the post, and Miller's got it. The fans behind the net thought it went in.
Wow.
Oh, wow.
They blew that call.
Oh, my goodness.
It wasn't even. It was so late. Not even the intent rule could roll in here. But I'm wondering why, in Toronto, that didn't get looked at and called in.
Like, anybody needs to face San Jose right now and to catch the Sharks maybe grumpy after getting accosted, after officials kind of cost them a point. Yeah.
They got ripped off, and they've lost three straight. Canucks and San Jose Thursday Sportsnet. And everybody talked about the Canucks having, well, not maybe easier competition to start the season.
Yeah.
Lately, though, hey, the Leafs run top. Say what you want. Mm-hmm. Leafs run top of the Eastern Conference, right, when they played them. Wings. Coyotes earlier this week, now the Sharks again.
It's a murderer's row right now with four straight against the Pacific Division. They got the Sharks again next week. But, you know, the one good thing, the power play is starting to show some signs of life. Yes, they struck for the second consecutive game Tuesday night, this time with a different look. John Tortorella threw four forwards out of the first unit using Ryan Kessler on the point. And it's something we'll likely see in San Jose as the Canucks try to turn around their struggling power play.
We think we have a couple of options there. Now that we have Burr back in the lineup, he can go in front of the net. It's one of his strengths. Kess has done a great job in front of the net, but also you have a shot, a right-hand shot also. And it helped us last night, scored a big goal for us. And we'll see where we go with it and go game to game.
It helps to you know, have a one-time option to open up some things, and then other things open. And if we shoot the puck, we got Burr in front and guys jamming the net.
Joined now by Dan Murphy down in beautiful Phoenix. And Murph, John Tortorella used four forwards in the first power play unit Tuesday against the Coyotes. Is this a trend Torts is going to use going forward?
I think so. For one reason, the Canucks scored a power play goal, and those have been hard to come by so far this season for the Vancouver Canucks. They liked using Kessler at the point because they want to free him up for that big shot of his. He crept down a little bit, huge one-timer from Henrik Sedin, and he scored. And this team has really struggled on the power play now. We're combining two seasons here, but if you go back to last season, the Canucks have had one multi-power play goal game in their last 55 outings, and that's got to change for them to win close games like the one last night against the Coyotes, a game where they had a power play in the third period to try to put the game away.
All right, let me ask you this, Murph. What's more troubling, the fact that Canucks always seem to give up the game's first goal or the fact they can't win in a shootout?
Well, I'd say both are equally troubling right now, but giving up the game's first goal hasn't really cost Vancouver. In games where the opponent has scored first, the Canucks 5-3-1. That's unheard of, and I don't know if they can keep up that pace, quite frankly, although it doesn't seem like being behind early has affected this team. As for the shootout, they're now 1-2, and the Canucks have scored just twice on 12 attempts. They have to give Roberto Luongo, who's been excellent, a little more help in that area, because Santarelli and Burrows are the only two guys who have managed to score so far in the shootout, and that's a big reason why the Canucks are 1-2 so far.
All right, after Tuesday's shootout loss, John Tortorella took some of the blame. He said, tying goal, late second period, shouldn't have had his fourth line out there. Your thoughts?
Yeah, post-game, he took the blame on himself, said, put that one on me. I was trying to stretch the bench, and I put out the fourth line late in the second, and I probably shouldn't have done that. So, he was taking the blame, but really, he was still blaming his fourth line, because saying they probably can't handle that type of situation. This is a guy who's really, really ridden his top guys hard, played that top line 23, 24 minutes a game, and now the second line of Higgins, Burrows, and Santarelli up around 20 minutes a game. So if that tying goal is any indication, I wouldn't expect to see the third or fourth line out there at final moments of periods in tight games or tie games, because Tortorella clearly doesn't believe that they should be out there now that they gave up that tying goal late in the second against the Phoenix Coyotes.
Thanks so much. A well-tanned Dan Murphy down in Phoenix, Arizona.